I give a round of applause to Tsukishima. I don't know. This has been Breakmaster here, and I just wanted to do this little discussion video because, you know, this chapter was about Tsukishima and Byakuya fighting and everything. You know, I always felt like, you know, Byakuya was supposed to pwn him and just get it over with, you know? Because, I mean, he's supposed to be, like, the strongest captain. But, you know, I got a little annoyed at first, but as I start watching the battle, it's actually pretty good. I mean, I don't know, it's probably one of the best battles we had in this arc, in the Bleach arc right now. I mean, yeah, in this Fullbring arc, is probably one of the better battles. At least between all the other fights we've just seen so far, because you know, Pachi owned, and, you know, the other one's kind of not really great, but this one's actually pretty good. It made sense to how he would have some trouble with him. After hitting his sword and getting to know his abilities and getting that 0 point zone, I mean, he was actually doing something. I mean, the thing is, basically, he knew all his sword attacks, so, you know, Byakuya had to just do one thing, switch up in the battlefield, because he has to change his tactics, because he knows all his tactics of fighting. So with that, he, you know, Tsukishima can always get close and mess up his rhythm, and then it just messes him up, and if he goes faster, he can hit himself, because, you know, he can't dodge the 0 point zone and stuff. And it's just like, you know, it made sense. It was actually a pretty good chapter. I actually really liked it. One of the better battles. So Tsukishima, good job. Though you died, because you were going to die, good job. But, you know, like Byakuya killed him, he just got some of his blades from his petal blades and ends up stabbing right through the heart and crack, killing him. So it's pretty beast of him. Byakuya, like, you know, he had a good fight. He even said he had a good fight, because it's like, he had to really think outside the box. He didn't have to just fight like he usually fights with everyone else, and then that's how he pwns him, because without his sword and his other abilities, and without his, you know, his keto or anything like that, he had to actually just go up close and start trying to get up to him, because he don't ever fight like that. So, no, I was pretty impressed by Tsukishima. So it was an impressive fight for see Tsukishima go this far anyway, because he's the longest running so far out of the, you know, the whatever they're called, I forgot what they're called right now, because I don't really but you know, it was nice. So yeah, tell me, leave a comment below. Did you like this fight? You know, is this one of the better ones that you've seen out of this arc, this you know, Fullbring arc? Are you guys liking it as much as I did? And you know, I'm curious what's gonna happen next, because I want to see. I'm not even really excited to see Genjo versus Ichigo right now. I mean, that fight was just like, it was actually pretty good. I don't know, the Genjo, it has Uryu in it. It kind of bothers me because Uryu's in it. Uryu don't need to be in it. It's 2-1. You know, Genjo's not even that strong anyway. It's not like Uryu can help him in any way anyway. But I don't know. I'm just a little ranting here because I don't know about this. But yeah, leave a comment below, tell me what you think. Like if you like the discussion video. And you know, subscribe to my channel for some more discussion of Bleach videos, because I'll try to do anything every week or so, depending on what happens in the chapter that I like to talk about. This is one of the things I like to talk about and get you guys' opinions on it as well. So yeah, it's been the Breakmaster Bleach 472 manga discussion. I keep about to say review, but yeah, it's been the Breakmaster. And until then, break out.